Well, the start of fall tends to be a reset for most families, and in some cases that includes considering their housing situation. Joining us this morning is Anthony Lamacchia of Lamacchia Realty, and you shared some information with us. I want to show it here because overall it looks like from the numbers that you were showing us, the number of houses sold in the last 2 years has dropped, actually in the last 2 or 3 years, but the price of those homes on average has creeped up. So what's going on in the housing market right now?
Well, year to date, if you measure from January to August 31st, home sales are down, call it 25%. Now, that's the total amount of sales.
Okay.
That's not prices. Prices are up about 2 to 3%.
Okay.
And that's confusing a lot of people. And
yeah.
The whole reason for this is the lack of people listing their homes.
Okay, so lower inventory means you're going to pay more for the houses that are listed.
Yeah, there's not enough to choose from.
Yeah.
So buyers have been fighting over houses. Now we're getting into the season that buyers won't fight over houses as much. We've actually entered the season that this is actually the best time of year to buy.
Okay.
Not the best time to sell. But best time to buy because there's less buyer competition.
Okay.
Out there.
Well, the other thing too is that always factors into this is interest rates.
Yep.
And you know, they've ticked up over the course of the time period that you showed us those stats. Where do the rates stand right now?
They're over 7.5%. Just the other day, they were 7.65 or something like that. I said July 8th, and I said it on the air once with you this summer, that I think we're going 8%.
Yep.
And I'm here to say on the live news right now that I believe we're going over 8%.
Okay,
and
so
I think it's
going
to happen in the next month.
Okay.
And these buyers that keep saying, well, I'll wait till they come down. Well, you're going to be waiting a year, year and a half.
Okay, so what can somebody do if they are going up and they would like it to be lower? There are some options.
There are. So there are mortgage buy-down programs, and we have it all spelled out on our webpage, myratebuydown.com, on our website. There are, so you can use buy-down options where you can negotiate with the seller to get a larger closing cost credit and take that amount of money, put it down on the mortgage.
Who's that right for?
Well, it depends. It's right for a lot of buyers.
Okay.
I mean, a lot of buyers can take advantage of that, and it gives you the equivalent of the lower rate. It might be 2 points lower or 3 points lower the first year, and then 2 or 1 point lower the second year. And by that time, rates should come back down.
You know, historically, these are not bad rates overall. I remember my father saying, like, in the 90s, like, the rates are never going to go below 7%.
Yeah.
They did. And and now, basically, we're spoiled, right?
Yeah. We literally have a spoiled society, all of us included.
Yes.
I mean, everybody got used to it. We have millions of people across the country that literally got addicted to 2.8 to 3.2% rates, and now the rates are having a bigger impact on the sellers than the buyers.
Because nobody wants to lose that great rate that they have. Yeah.
So people think, you know, customarily, oh, rates go up, buyers must be mad, buyers must be holding back. Not really. Is there less demand? Yes, but it's not comparative to how many less sellers there are.
Yeah, because that's going to impact what your equity can go toward when you move.
Correct. And sellers are saying, well, I'm not giving up my rate. I'll just wait. And that's literally the whole country.
The other thing I wanted to ask you about is how would a government shutdown impact all of this?
If it shuts down for 3 days, a week, so that both sides can say, raw, we shut it down, there isn't going to be very much impact. If it starts going on 2 weeks, 3 weeks, or like in 2018 when it went on 35 days, it can screw things up in the sense that, you know, tax transcripts that the IRS has to get to mortgage companies,
aren't going
to
come.
Those get delayed.
Yeah.
Some folks at the Federal Housing, you know, Agency, that some things there get slowed down. So things get slowed down, but, I mean, I've been doing this 19 years. I feel like every 2 or 3 years I hear about government shutdown, it's going to crush sales.
Right.
And every time, you know, we might see a delayed sale, but it doesn't really do anything.
So calm, everybody calm
down.
Everybody's
got to roll.
Everybody, calm down. Where can people find you, Anthony?
LamacchiaRealty.com.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us, Catherine. Over to you.